hard in character with less volatility and high melting and boiling point. So most widely the elements comes under D block category are precious and industrially important elements. Let us have variation between atomic radii and ionic radii. Variation between atomic radii and ionic radii. Let us have, like in general discussion, in case of D block elements, while we are moving from scandium to zinc, that means from left side to right side, scandium to zinc, or from left side of the periodic table to right side of the periodic table, by increasing number of protons at nucleus. So what is this statement here? While we are moving from scandium to zinc, or ritium to cadmium, or lanthanum to mercury, so slightly increasing, one unit increase of positive charge identified at nucleus due to increase of atomic number, scandium 21, where zinc 30. So while we are moving slightly or slightly from left side to right side in a periodic table, increasing number of proton, that means positive character of nucleus increases. Here, by increasing positive character, when the positive character of the nucleus increases, the attraction of nucleus onto the valency orbit also increases. When the nucleus strongly attracts valency orbit, so what will be expected one? The nucleus will going to attract the valency orbit, then valency orbit somewhat comes close to the nucleus. That means decrease in atomic radii from left side to right side in a period. That means from scandium to zinc, or yttrium to cadmium, or lanthanum to mercury, here decrease in atomic radii observed. So this is the general concept, but the amount of decrease in atomic radii slightly vary in a period. It will slightly vary in this periods. Means sometimes the high decrease in atomic radii, sometimes less decrease in atomic radii observed during scandium to zinc, or while we are moving from left side of the periodic table to right side of the periodic table in D block elements. So this is atomic radii. What is ionic radii? When we are going to eliminate, as they are metals and with more electropositive character, so we can eliminate the electron from the valency orbit by using some amount of energy, that is called as ionization enthalpy. So while we are going to eliminate electron from the valency orbit, there is the generation of positive ions. That means neutral atoms are converted into positive ions. So the positive ions, when formation of positive ions takes place, there is a possibility of more attraction observed onto the valency orbit by nucleus, which can facilitate furthermore decrease in ionic radii. So this is about atomic radii, the variation between atomic radii and ionic radii in case of D block elements, where the next topic is ionization enthalpies. Ionization enthalpy. Or ionization enthalpies. So it is very clear that while we are moving from scandium to zinc in 3D series or 4D, 5D, 6D, 6D series, while we are moving left to right, atomic size decreases due to increase in net attraction force by nucleus onto the valency orbit. When atomic size decreases, the amount of energy used or required to eliminate electrons from valency orbit increases. That means from scandium to zinc or left to right, regarding d block element, from left to right, ionization enthalpies increases. Left to right, as per general concept, left to right, ionization enthalpies decreases. Ionization enthalpies increases due to decrease in atomic size. But these transition elements slightly vary ionization enthalpy values from one element to another element. Why? Because some factors will influence us. What are the factors? In case of atomic radii or ionic radii, the most important factor is which can decide ionic or atomic sizes. Lanthanide contraction. So this is the most important case. I would like to explain here. Lanthanide contraction. So what is lanthanide contraction means? While we are going to fill electrons in the respected d block elements, first elements filled in 4f orbital, then only 5d orbital. So first electrons takes place in 4f orbital. First electrons filled in 4f, then only 5d orbital. When first electrons occupy 4f orbital followed by 5d orbital, this concept is called as lanthanide contraction. So this lanthanide contraction leads to effect, or it shows its effect on atomic radii or ionic radii in d block elements. So after this, once again come to ionization enthalpy. As we know that the amount of energy required to eliminate electron from valency orbit of given element is called as ionization enthalpy. So the ionization enthalpy generally inversely proportional to atomic size, where those transition elements with lesser atomic size to eliminate electron from their valency orbit, we have to use huge amount of energy. So as a general concept, from left to right, that is in 3D, 4D, 5D and 6D series, while we are moving left to right, as atomic size decreases, so ionization enthalpy values increases. And next one, slightly vary, means ionization enthalpy values in kilojoule per mole. It is expressed in kilojoule per mole. The ionization enthalpy values will vary here. The amount of ionization enthalpy will be like this: delta H 1 is greater than, is less than delta H, 2 is less than delta H, 3. What is this? To eliminate first electron from the neutral atom, we have to use less amount of energy than to eliminate second electron from the same atom. Similarly, to eliminate third electron in the same atom, we have to use huge amount of energy when compared to second electron. So this is delta H1 is less than delta H2 is less than delta H3. It is expressed in kilojoule per mole. And one more factor which influences ionization enthalpies of d block elements are stability, more stable electron configuration. As I explained just now, some of the elements in the periodic table or d block elements will exhibit more stable electron configuration. That means due to half filled or full filled d orbital.